You are watching Sammy, the Interviewing Toucan, made possible by the Indiana Young Reader Center. Hey, everybody, I'm Sammy, and I'm here today with Teresa Robeson. Hi, Teresa, how are you?
I'm good, Sammy. How are you doing?
I'm great. It's so nice to talk to you. I love that you're with us via your car today. Can you tell us a little bit about why that is? Because you're our first author that's joined us from a car.
Well, I live out in the country, so the only internet that I can get is satellite internet. It's a little bit iffy sometimes. So the car has its cellular internet, and it happens to work great.
Oh my gosh. I love that. I love that. That's so great. Well, Teresa, tell me a little bit about yourself and your connection to Indiana.
Okay. Well, like I said, I live out in the country. I live on a little mini homestead with my scientist husband and our younger son and a flock of chickens. In fact, I have chickens for my seat cover. We grow a lot of our own foods, and occasionally we harvest our own chickens. So in addition to writing, I'm also the co-regional advisor for the Indiana chapter of the Society of Children's Book Writers and Illustrators, which is a really great organization. I encourage everybody who's interested in writing to join it. And also, I have far too many hobbies and not enough time to do them all. So I was born in Hong Kong and raised in Vancouver, British Columbia. I met my husband actually at the University of British Columbia when he was doing grad studies. And when he got offered a job here in Indiana in 1992, we moved out here and we've been living here ever since.
Oh, I love that. And I guess, I mean, I have to say something about your chicken situation. I'm glad you live on a farm. It sounds sustainable. I guess that's all I'll say, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. So tell us a little bit more about your work. I have one of your books here. This is your debut book, Queen of Physics. And I know you have another book coming out. So tell us a little bit more about your work.
So I write for all ages. And like you said, I have a couple of picture books that have been published. Queen of Physics, which you have there. And this is Two Bicycles in Beijing. And so Queen of Physics, I was so excited. It's my debut, but got a NCTE, National Council of Teachers of English, Orbis Pictus recommended book, and it also won the 2020 Asian Pacific American Librarians Association Award for picture books. So I'm really excited about that. And I have some upcoming books that I can't talk about yet, but I'm really super excited about them.
I love those. I think that's so great when you have announcements that you can't share. Ah, okay. That's fantastic. So where are you in your creative journey as an author, and where do you hope to be someday? It sounds like you have all kinds of interests in life. Talk to us a little bit more about your writing journey.
So I started writing back in the early 90s, and I was published in magazines like Ladybug and Babybug and Outdoor Indiana too, even. But I took some time off when my kids were younger to homeschool them and raise them. And then I got back into writing at around 2010. That's when I thought, I think I can write books instead of just, you know, short stories and poetry and stuff. So I started doing that. So right now, in addition to working on picture books, I'm also working on a couple of middle grade manuscripts. So one is nonfiction and one is contemporary, and also alternative history, young adult novel. And for that Sunday, yeah, I know, so exciting. For that Sunday, I hope to be an author of, you know, novels in addition to picture books. And of course, I'd like to win more awards. Who wouldn't, right?
Absolutely. That's totally true. Who wouldn't want to win more awards? That sounds great. Teresa, I know you talked about your internet a little bit, and, you know, internet connectivity is so important right now with the health crisis. It's almost like a human right at this point. We really need it in order to stay connected to each other. How are you coping right now with the health crisis? And do you have any advice for others?
You know, we're really lucky to have the mini homestead that we do, and we grow a lot of our own food. So, you know, we don't want for much, and it hasn't really affected us as much as, you know, for some other people. And being quarantined is actually a really good thing for introverts like me. So I have you know, an excuse to not go out and do anything. But I know it's hard for a lot of other people, you know, who have to work, or extroverts that want to connect with other people. For me, my advice would be, if you're stuck at home and you really can't go anywhere, learn something new. Learning something new will help time pass quicker and also give your mind something else to focus on besides sitting there and feeling miserable. So like, for example, our public library offers these free language programs for you to go learn a new language. I think it's a program called Mango, and you can go learn a language for free with your library card. And, you know, also YouTube videos can teach you everything you want to know.
That's so true. And I'll just take this second to talk quickly about Inspire. Do you know about inspire.in.gov, Teresa? Have you heard of that?
No, I haven't. Thank you.
So, I'll write it down. Yeah, inspire.in.gov is actually a database suite that the state of Indiana pays for all Indiana residents. And it also has language software on there, which is free for everyone to use. So you don't even need a library card for that one. So there's 30 different languages, and you get free access to level one for Rosetta Stone. And I know Mango is great too. So, you know, all kinds of stuff. Go out there and learn a language, everybody. I love that. Well, Teresa, I'm inviting all of our authors to share something. Do you have something there to share for show and tell today?
I sure do. Look at this. This is mini me.
I hope your camera is gonna cooperate. There it is. Okay, yeah. Aww. There we go. Oh, I love it. It's a little mini figure.
Yeah, so I wanted to share this Lego minifigure that a friend of mine gave me. So it represents a lot of and about me. Friendship, first of all, because my friend Tom gifted this to me. Aww. And Lego, because I've been playing with Legos for like 5 decades. And I still play with them. And Star Trek. I don't know if you can see that. Star Trek.
Yeah, that's so great.
Because I was raised by Star Trek, the first generation, you know, the original series. Mm-hmm. So anyway, Star Trek gave me my beliefs and convictions. And the hat, see the hat?
That
represents my activism.
I love it. So, I love it. That's great. And it sounds like you've got all kinds of things going on at the homestead. So that is really fun. It's been so delightful talking to you today.
Thank you, Sammy. I enjoyed this a lot.
Well, hey, everybody. This is your favorite Hoosier Toucan encouraging you to read local. So long, everybody.